headlines. After Assistant Registrar Cooperative Society Office Savombung was set on fire in 2011, government paid no attention till today. Hello and welcome to ISTV English News. Let's see the news in detail now. The Assistant Registrar Cooperative Society Imphal East 1 office located at Savombung was set on fire by unknown persons in the year 2011. Since then, no authority concerned paid heed till today. Due to this, the staff of the office are facing a lot of inconveniences in functioning the office smoothly. After the office was set on fire, the office was shifted to a private, shabby, southeastern bakery unit at Kongpal Khaidem Lekai temporarily. The tables and almirahs, which are a bit burnt and rescued from the inferno, were still used by the staff at the temporary office. A staff member, on condition of anonymity, informed the ISTV News that after the incident occurred, the government had provided some plastic chairs and two curtains only. As the only typing machine was also damaged during the inferno, during office documentation and paperwork, the staff used to go to a private computer center by spending money. However, for office purposes, the staff used carbon paper and handwritten documents. The temporary office has neither power nor drinking water facility. This has caused a big problem in the functioning of the office. On the other hand, people who came to the office for various purposes also faced dissatisfaction over the work process the staff take up, as work cannot be completed at stipulated time due to the prevailing conditions. The government of Manipur had taken up many developmental works in both hill and valley districts, but it is a matter of utter surprise that an office which was set on fire 5 years back is not repaired and looked into still. Staff of the office appealed to the authority concerned to look into the pathetic condition of the office and take up a concrete step at the earliest. Talking to the ISTV News, a person who came to the office also drew the attention of the government to look into the matter.
Barazu, Lam Chang, Chapiki problem later, Aduga Lak, but the Zumu, Stab Sing, Lerum, Belerum, the Ba, Sinising, but some Sammy Amzi Praza, the thing of Haita, Aduna, Hui Sigisida, Prazamuina, a Quigi, Kungangi, Kusirolam, the labor Prazamuin, Hygiening Buddy, a Quigi, Imai Bill Sing, Santolam, Biwalaba, Praza, Quigi, the Mutti, Miraganda, Hana Lerumba, Sumum Gloki, the Lerumba, Opis, Labor Kidna, Mapula, and Tokraba, Nasina, Mapamzaida.
Two men were injured in a road mishap today morning. The incident happened around 9:30 in the morning today at Dinku Road near Hyundai showroom. According to reports received by the ISTV News, a team of Motor Vehicle Information of Motor Vehicle Department Imphal East tried to stop an auto rickshaw. When the driver refused to stop, they hit the window panes of the auto rickshaw using baton, and suddenly the auto lost its control and the mishap occurred. The injured persons were identified as W. Victor, 47, son of late Rabai, a resident of Laifam Kunau, the driver of the auto, and Rishi San, 47, son of Kong Lui, a resident of Litan TM Kashom, Ukrul district, who was sitting on the passenger seat. The injured persons are undergoing treatment at JNIMS Hospital at present. A person who witnessed the entire scene explained to the ISTV News. On the other hand, the driver of the auto rickshaw, Victor, expressed condemnation over the acts of the motor vehicle information team.
mina gari thoro idu speed thudu bo idu khamur thoro khama idu bo karan ngam gudu ge ba ada sai to khang ge na khanma chom de chu agi left thudu gari ngam jali ai bagal lom dai ni aru tu ge bo ba le
tu ye
ba sai ka re ni se ba ge de ai su ai pre kao mo ra tu chom na la le pai tha ni na lam de si de ba de ai khara ge
42 Assam Rifles under the aegis of IGAR South inaugurated a community hall at Akho Kamasom village in Ukhrul district, stated a press release issued by PRO of IGAR South. Moray Police in collaboration with Shija Hospital Imphal organized a free medical camp at Moray Additional SP Complex. Many people, including people from Myanmar, were also given treatment at the camp. Medicines were also provided free of cost. New representatives of Manipur Students Federation, MSF, Imphal West District Committee 2016-17 were elected. Kundrakpam Somokanta of Imphal College was elected president and Oinam Umajit as general secretary. Three vice presidents and other 11 office bearers were also elected respectively. During yet another spot investigation at border pillar number 7 at Choro village by the ISTV news team and Icham team, president of Information Center for Hill Areas Manipur, Icham N. Rajendra, has cautioned that a huge agitation of the people is going to follow if the ongoing Indo-Myanmar boundary issue pertaining to losing vast tracts of land by India and Myanmar India and Manipur due to the installation of border pillars at the wrong places it is not resolved at the earliest.
Akhoina isamna Manipur government da haining libadi achum chum da report ama akhoi ngasi yokre Manipur gi praja singna sembalai ngakni praja singna sei manga manga gi vote piraga makhoina chief minister wari bani MLA wari bani minister wari bani adubu ngasi bawda sei 2013 da gina sei ahum phara bawbu sida Manipur ki praja section khuding mangna border da leiba igi isin naw maya mana khoi gi lamang da ore mange mange na lawbu sita ngasi phawbu da ngasi gi khoi phamnai ba singna border area da leiba igi sin gi sinaw sing maru ina sing gi khula ko pawsa sing kaur kan da NGO kaur kan da tanab gi mohot kari su khang da ba survey india na dum lol ga leiba se khoi gi praja sing sin ma khoi da voting right ma khak pir ga ma khoi na Manipur gi langak pai ba ne se kawbra Tasing na makoy na Manipur gi, akoy gi luching ba mo ibitar gadi. Manipur gi kasin ko yada gi ay gi. Samjak ra ba akoy gi ching khulak pa sing ipay pu sing na ngapir na boundary do. Sini na thola ibay gi chinaw sing si. Kaurer ga onarun same gi table da. Tanu bi mam thok tapra magi praja mo ibitar gadi. Makoy na ngasib awo da masi gi kongta amal akoy lakte bisina. Akoy samday hena samal na malidi. Boray yada lay ba si makoy gi praja na tapra ay gi. Wang do ni isam na ngasib government da hangjening isi. Yam na tatna. Akhoina government da pindo busi lamme chi ma mangaloi de haibo 2013 dagi ngasi baul sai ohma pung phare adubu ngasi phau gi manung sida solo solo ma pawna bang ngasi government sina hona ba udri irang tholo kan da di lamme chi ma mangaloi haidana assembly dena trage any miam gi platform am da tatna lawi adu law ra gadi akhoina pamjari bana mana lawri du gi art thongna khunja jing gi tawr ga kadai dagi na kadai bawno kadai dagi na kadai bawno khang ga kan da Manipur government na survey of india brahma ga he na masi gi akhoi gi ari ba boundary ma ya thok pu da nungai na ma thabak to hoji pa pa khat pidri se kari gi no masi athum ma tham da pa khat piu ma du pa khat na survey of india ga ta ngai ga leitar ga di Manipur a chau ba irang ma lakani akhoi gi border sin ma ra mo ra ga adu na athu ma tham da Manipur government ma se pa khat piu ha ba apil du ni sam
Talking to the ISTV News, Chief of the village, Kapungyi Asare, said the pillar is erected at a point which is more than 3 kilometers away from the actual Indo-Myanmar border.
Jai, akoi na pillar number 7 da lebi bisi, akoi na hanagi traditional boundary sinati. Makoi na handa anova, shem laga adu de sidil yungibni, ma sidigi na eastern Burma border om da kilometer mari gumba hom gumba si lebni adu lebe jaga do akoi na kramai na proof phangbra ga tik ta sar ga yumba adu le rame hanedi ngaram lahan ei thibida adu uhaudre adu re jaga makte ei phajar khang ngame adu mesidi kina distance si kilometer phajan de on de o hom bu hen gni ai ne dum ka thajai
In national news Prime Minister Narendra Modi will inaugurate the World Sufi Forum in New Delhi today. The four-day event is being organized by All India Ulama and Masaiq Board, AIUMB, the apex body of Sufi Dargahs in India. More than 200 Indian and international delegates, including Sufi Shuyukh, spiritual leaders, scholars, academicians and masters of Sufism, are participating in the event. The meeting is expected to debate on how Sufi teaching can prevent global terrorism. The conclave will also debate on how to guide the Muslim community away from sectarian division. The organizers also said a debate on role of women in Islam will be conducted in the international conference. The Sufi conference is expected to come out with a declaration against extremism and Wahhabism in the last day of the event to be convened in the Ram Leela Maidan. One of Vijay Mallya's flagship properties in Mumbai, Kingfisher House, is being auctioned online today. The base price for the office at Andheri in Mumbai's western suburbs has been fixed at Rs. 150 crore. The e-auction is being managed by an arm of the state-run State Bank of India, one of the 17 banks trying to recover at least $1 billion loaned to Mr. Mallya's grounded Kingfisher Airlines. At least 15 offers are reportedly in. The auction is taking place a day before Mr. Mallya has been summoned for questioning as part of an investigation related to one of the bank loans. Mr. Mallya is reportedly in the UK amid attempts to recover over Rs. 6,000 crore loaned to Kingfisher Airlines, which stopped operating in 2012. Ranked the 45th richest Indian with a net worth of $1 billion by Forbes in March 2012, Mr. Mallya is known to have lavish homes in Mumbai, Goa, Delhi and also London. His flamboyant lifestyle also features a fleet of luxury cars and a yacht. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, who was targeted by the Congress in Parliament over the tycoon's escape, said every penny from Mallya will be recovered. Denmark is the world's happiest country, while Burundi is the least happy, according to a new survey. The fourth World Happiness Report also found that countries where there was less inequality were happier overall. Switzerland, Iceland, Norway and Finland, which like Denmark, have strong social security systems, made up the rest of the top five. The US is the world's 13th happiest country. The UK was 23rd, China 83rd and India 118th. The two-day meeting of South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, SAARC Council of Foreign Ministers, is stated to begin in Pokhara in Nepal today. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj arrived in Pokhara yesterday to attend the meet. The foreign secretaries of all SAARC countries yesterday discussed ways to implement plans to improve connectivity, counter-terrorism and other issues. Ms. Swaraj, along with her counterparts from SAARC countries, will discuss the progress made on the programs approved at the last summit of the Regional Association in Kathmandu in 2014. The headlines once again. After Assistant Registrar Cooperative Society Office, Sawombung, was set on fire in 2011, government paid no attention till today. Thanks for joining us and do stay tuned for more updates.